Lord.
Good to see you. For those of you who do not have a church that you go to, we'd like to welcome you here to Colonial Heights Christian. Since we built our new gymnasium over here, that's our worship center B, I believe it is called. This is called Worship Center A and Worship Center B. We'd like to invite you to come and visit with us. The Lord's here.
Yes, he is.
The Lord is another church that said, never ever forget that. There are so many people, and I grew up years ago in the Christian church. Back then, they used to say Christian church is the only ones where you're going to go to heaven, so you've got to come to our church. I don't agree with that. There's Christians everywhere, all over this world.
That's
there's
right.
There's Christians that don't go to church.
That's right.
Can you believe that? Do you have to go to church to be saved? No, no, I can't. Okay. But there are people who can't go to church because they are sick. There are some people that may live out in the boondock, way out in the boondock, like the programs in Alaska. They can't go to church. But you don't go to church to worship the Lord. You see, you are the church.
Yes.
If you're a member of God's church, see, we're all together here. It doesn't matter if you're this church or that church. What does God want from you? Just your heart. That's all he wants, is your heart. And how does he get your heart? You give it to him a little bit at a time. Just a little bit. We have to go through so many things in this life. But if you can call yourself a Christian, a born-again believer, there, this is one day at a time. Remember that song? One day at a time, Lord Jesus, is all that I'm asking of you. No, I will not be going to Nashville. It's not in my stars. Some of you may be. We have some beautiful singers here. But you don't have to go to church. I say, go to church. Fellowship with your fellow brothers and sisters in Christ. So, you know, we only have just a few minutes to talk to you when we all come in here on a Monday morning. And usually, I try to make a little bit of a quick impact out of that there. And it would be so nice if the Word of God could be preached in a way that's loving and kind and sweet and all that. But the Word of God sometimes, he gets very bold and very blunt about some of the things he expects of us. And he does expect quite a bit. We will never get to heaven by ourselves. We can only get there through his grace and his love that he gives to each and every one of us. I love the concept in the book. Y'all know about the potter, you know, the potter that is making the clay.
Yeah.
And he puts his hand in water, and as the table turns, he's making the pottery the way he wants to make it. And he filled with his hands all these little lumps, and he's trying to get the lumps out. Lumps represent sin. So he's filling this, and he takes it out, and he throws it on the ground because it is no value. When you become a born again believer in Christ, he takes you and he puts you on his potter's table. And that wheel turns, which represents a long time. It's turning and turning. And God will stop it every now and then and get that little impurity out of your heart, because we have a lot of impurities in our heart. The Lord's, the Word says that the heart is desperately wicked. Do you feel wicked? Does anybody feel wicked? You feel wicked?
Some days.
I notice now that over the years, as I get older, and I'll be 70 next month, praise God, but I know that as I get older, I can look at myself. I don't have to look in the mirror. I look in the Word, because the Word tells me that I am. And I'm a wicked person. Because in a moment's time, a split moment's time, I can be one of the best Christians walking around, and all of a sudden something happens, and I burn out some.
Yep.
That I should not be doing. And you can do the same thing with being angry. And I've heard of Christians murdering others there. Because in a split moment there, the flesh takes over and the spirit is not in control. But believe it or not, you're desperately wicked. That's what I was talking about a while ago, that the Lord could be very blunt. And he's very blunt, but he has to be blunt to be able to make an impression on who you really are. He tells us about wearing filthy rags, that our clothes are like filthy rags. Well, you see, clothes on the outside of you, right? Clothes on the outside. They're not on the inside. So if someone sees your filthy, dirty, nasty clothes, that's your body. With clothes on. And don't we get that way sometimes? Don't we? Can you be honest with yourself and say, that's me.
Oh,
a couple of weeks ago, I was here. And when I left here, I went out to get in the line because they had some extra cantaloupes they were trying to get, so I'd give away. So I said, I'll give a cantaloupe. Okay, I will. So I got in line and pulled it in line on the hill there a little bit. And I put it up in reverse, and I bent over to pick a little cup out of the floor. And I didn't realize I didn't put it any marker, I had it in reverse. So I started backing up, and I was leaning over. I didn't know I was backing up. All of a sudden, the horn started blowing. There, and the guy started backing up, blowing his horn, and then I heard the word, damn idiot!
Oh.
His wife and girlfriend. So I just put it in the park, and I got out of my vehicle. Her eyes got real big, and she realized it was me. And the guy was kind of holding on the steering wheel like that, so I just walked over. And I said, I'm sorry, sir, I did not mean to do that. And then I said, dear lady, I am an idiot, but I am not damned.
That's right. That's right.
You were all idiots.
Yes.
Trust in the Lord. Come to Him with a contrite heart and believing heart.
Yeah.
We love to feed you and give you what the Lord gives us to give to you. But our main reason is to bring you to Jesus.
Yes.
That's what we want to do. If we can do that, that's all that matters to us. And that's all that matters to Him.
Praise the Lord.
If anyone of you need to talk or pray or just whatever you need to do, I'll be available here. And we'll talk about that. Let's have a word of prayer before we go. Father God, I pray your name. Praise the name of my Savior Jesus who died for me. And yes, Lord, I am here. There's times I do things that I apologize for, and I come before you without need, asking for your forgiveness, dear. And I need forgiveness. We all need forgiveness. And Christ brought that forgiveness by the cross. And we praise Him. And I praise you for all those that are here this morning. I pray you watch over them and keep them. I pray you keep them. Give them good health. Just give them the purpose, Father, that they can see that they need you and nobody else. And we praise you in Jesus' name. Thank you. Thank you. God bless you.
Amen.